Today we are going to learn about density modification of cryo-EM maps using resolved cryo-EM in the Phenix GUI. Density modification uses expectations about one part of a map to improve another part of the map. The original map on the left is implausible. It has a noisy solvent and its density profile is unlike that of typical protein because it contains noise. The density modified map on the right is more plausible with flat solvent and density histograms similar to those of typical proteins. Let's density modify a cryo-EM map now. We are going to use the 1.8 angstrom map of human apoferritin from the Phenix density modification tutorial. In the main Phenix GUI, select New Project, then click on Set Up Tutorial Data and select a dataset. Scroll down to the cryo-EM section and select Human Apoferritin Density Modification at 1.8 angstroms. Then click OK. There will now be a new apoferritin project with tutorial data in a new directory. We can click on it to select it. Let's run density modification now. Click on cryo-EM to show the cryo-EM tools. Scroll down and hit the Resolve cryo-EM button to load the cryo-EM density modification tool. We are going to run starting with two half maps. These should be unmasked and as unprocessed as possible. Let's put in a title. Let's put in the two half maps. They are in the directory that was created when we set up the tutorial. The half maps are already cut out from the original maps and are called halfmap1 and 2 boxed.ccp4. The resolution of our map is about 2 angstroms. The best value of the resolution for density modification is usually a little smaller than the map resolution. We could leave it blank, but let's specify it as 1.8 angstroms. Now let's add a sequence file. This tells Resolve cryo-EM about the size of our molecule. Let's uncheck the Box Before Analysis box because our map is already boxed. Let's use all 4 of our processors. And let's density modify unsharpened maps. This sometimes helps for high-resolution maps. The alternative is to use maps with half map sharpening applied. We're ready to go. Hit Run to start density modification. After about 15 minutes, we get a new Results tab that shows us the resolution used in density modification, the starting resolution, the final resolution, and the estimated improvement. The next tab shows the Fourier shell correlation of the starting half maps. Notice that the correlation is very high until the resolution gets close to 1.9 angstroms. The final tab shows the estimated map quality of original and density modified maps as a function of resolution. The light brown curve shows that the original map is about 50% correlated with the true but unknown map at a resolution of 1.9 angstroms. The blue curve shows that the density modified map crosses that threshold at slightly finer resolution. Notice that the blue curve is higher than the brown one at all resolutions between 1.9 and 2.5 angstroms. That means that the density modified map is better in this resolution range. Let's look at our original and density modified maps. In the Files tab, select Open in Qt. This opens our map. Let's load in a model from an X-ray structure refined against the original map. This model is supplied with the tutorial and is called apoferritin chain A RSR.pdb. And let's load in that original map that comes with the tutorial. Here is the original map in yellow, and here is the density modified map in the same region. The model based on the X-ray structure has 2 conformations for the phenylalanine. There is just 1 in this cryo-EM structure, and it is seen very clearly in the density modified map. The density modified map is generally more clear than the original map, but the low resolution aspects of the 2 maps are very similar because the original map already had very good low resolution information. Good luck with using Resolve cryo-EM on your map. If you have questions or feedback, you are welcome to contact us at help@phoenixonline.org or tutorials@phoenixonline.org.